Hello students, this is Sir Murtaza from Al Murtaza School and welcome you to another lecture of physics. So let's start. So today in this lecture video, we are going to start our new chapter and this chapter's name is kinematics. Okay, we have done with the chapter physical quantities and measurement, and after completing that chapter, we are going to start another chapter and the name of this chapter is kinematics. Okay, so we will look onto the agenda, what topics or what SLOs we are going to cover in this lecture video. So we are going to discuss the following SLOs. Number one, we will discuss define rest and motion. We will look onto the definition of rest and motion. What is rest? What is motion? And we will learn about describe using examples how objects can be at rest and in motion. Okay. So let's move a little more further. So first of all, we are going to talk about kinematics. As the chapter's name is kinematics, so we should definitely know what is actually a kinematics. What is the definition of kinematics? So the definition of kinematics is, it is the branch of science in which we study about the motion of an object without discussing the cause of motion. Okay, so basically it is a branch of science. Okay. And in that branch of science, what we do, we study about the motion of an object without discussing the cause of motion. Okay. Now, what does it mean? It means that we have seen a lot of things around us, which is being in motion, or you could say that they are moving around. Okay. So in kinematics, what we do, we study about the motion of an object. And another thing, the cause for a body to move is force. Okay. We definitely know. And also there are some other factors too. But in kinematics, we are only concerned with the motion of an object and we do not discuss the causes of motion. Okay, so we do not discuss the causes of motion in kinematics. Just we have to study about the motion of an object. Okay, so kinematics, it is a branch of science in which we study about the motion of an object without discussing the cause of motion. Okay, now here comes the definition, rest. So what do you first get an idea by listening to the word rest? So you could assume something. You could say that rest means if a body is resting. What does it mean? If a body, for example, if I say I'm resting, it means I'm having a sleep. Okay, or I'm just sitting on a chair, I'm resting. Okay, so this is the formal definition that comes in your mind when you look onto the word rest. But what is its definition in physics? The definition in physics of rest is, a body is said to be at rest when, if it does not changes its position with respect to its surrounding. Okay, so for a body to be at rest, what does it should do? It should not change its position with respect to its surrounding. Okay, if you see that an object is not moving its position with respect to its surrounding, it means that the body is in the state of rest. Okay, state of rest means state kehte hain halat ko. ठीक है, यानी रेस्ट की हालत में है. तो व्हेनेवर अ बॉडी इज एट रेस्ट, यू कुड से दैट इट डज नॉट चेंजेस इट्स पोजीशन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू इट्स सराउंडिंग. ओके, सो लेट्स लुक ऑन टू सम एग्जांपल. वन कॉमन एग्जांपल इज अ टेबल ऑन अ फ्लोर. ओके, फॉर एग्जांपल दिस इज अ टेबल व्हिच इज सेट ऑन अ फ्लोर और व्हिच इज प्लेस्ड ऑन अ फ्लोर. सो दैट इज इन द स्टेट ऑफ रेस्ट. Why it is in the state of rest? Because it is not changing its position with respect to its surrounding. Okay. Okay. One more thing. With respect to its surrounding, what does it mean? We will talk about it a little later. But just you have to remember, whenever a body is not changing its position, it means that it is in the state of rest. Okay. Very simple. The example is, for example, a table on a floor. Okay. Now we will look on to the definition of motion. Now what is motion? The definition of motion is, a body is said to be at motion when, if it changes its position with respect to its surrounding. Okay, now whenever you see a body which is changing its position with respect to its surrounding, it means that the body is in the state of motion, or simply you could say the body is at motion. Okay, when, if it is changing its position with respect to its surrounding. Okay, so there are a lot of examples. One example could be a car moving on a road. Okay, so whenever you see cars which are moving on a road, they are continuously changing its position. Okay, first it is in front of you, then it is moving away from you. It means that the body or the car is continuously changing its position, it means that the body is in motion. Okay, now you get the idea of what is rest, what is motion. Rest, if a body does not change its position. Motion, if a body changes its position. Okay, so in this chapter we will be having a very elaboration about the motion. Just you have to remember the definition of rest, and what we have to study is we have to study about the motion. Okay, now there is an example. Okay, how an object can be at rest and in motion. Okay, sometimes it happens that the body is at rest and also at motion simultaneously at a time. Okay, so when does this happen? Okay, you say that the body is at rest and it is also at motion. So let's look on to this. You know, the state of rest or motion of a body is relative. Okay, the rest and motion are relative terms. Okay, how? For example, a passenger sitting in a moving bus is at rest because he or she is not changing his or her position with respect to other passengers or objects in the bus. Okay, here you will get the idea about what actually means with respect to its surrounding. So here one example is, for example, you're sitting in a bus. Okay, so you are the passenger. So when you are sitting in the bus, you are in the state of rest. For whom? For those person who are also sitting with you. For example, I am sitting here. For example, suppose that I am in a bus, okay, and another passenger is sitting besides me. Okay, so for both of us, we are at rest because we are not changing our position with respect to the other passengers or the objects in the bus. Okay, but to an observer outside the bus, the passenger and the objects inside the bus are in motion. Okay, so for example, I'm sitting in a bus and a friend looks me away outside the bus. Okay, so for that friend, he is the observer. Okay, and he see me as in motion. Why? Because I'm continuously changing my position. So it means that with respect to the observer, I am in the state of motion, but while sitting in the bus, with respect to my passenger, I am in the state of rest. Okay, so this is an example. Whenever you are sitting in a bus or in a car or in a motorbike, so what it happens is, with respect to surrounding, you have got the idea that for the passenger whom I am sitting beside, I am at rest. But for example, an observer who is outside the bus, for him, I am in the state of motion. So here you can say that sometimes a body can be at rest and also at motion with respect to different surroundings. Okay, hopefully you have understood this concept. So this is for this video. Hopefully you have understand. And this is the example. For example, this is a bus where you are sitting. Okay, so this is it for this video. Hope you have understood this topic. This was just an introductory video for the chapter kinematics. Just we have learned about rest and motion, and we have seen an example how a body can be at rest and also at motion. Okay, so this is it. We'll inshallah meet you soon in the next lecture. So till then, take care of yourself and